Now that we're qualifying, we can also start our recording. We just explode into existence with qualifying in progress. We got our setups to 99%. So it's a matter of whether we got the speeds. I didn't realize, like, being in qualifying would moralize or demoralize a driver. But I guess some drivers expect to be a part of it. Yeah, the daughter looks like she's a bit faster. Okay. A whole second. There's a lot of pace we've found in this car now. I'm happy it's a problem we were able to solve, at least. Houghton. Really? You're really gonna do me like that, huh? Alright, we'll try to get this number up. I had car 2 at 99%, so car 1 is what we're still trying to... We're still trying to figure out. Oh, Houghton, why are you losing rating? Let the tires fall into cold too. I did try manual last night just to see what it was like. Just generally not good laps. Houghton should have all the pace advantage and just is not driving like it. Just trying to find something that works. Ninety-eight is perfectly acceptable, honestly. Sponsorships is going to be our greatest liability. No improvement from either driver, which... young daughter started by setting the bar pretty dang high. Olivia Vanderstead. Nice. I guess it's all down to whether Houghton feels like driving a good lap here at the end. Good warm up. First sector. What's sector two gonna look like? They don't give me much. She does improve some. I guess we'll see if the AI improve. We fall to fourth. Kujawiak pulls for Lancaster, which doesn't mean a whole lot because Lancaster ain't doing much of anything this season. It's strange how we all qualify our finishing positions. Very, very weird. Anyway. Nope. Do that. 99% for everybody. Let me start with Houghton. Let's start with Laura, since theoretically she's going to be the weakest driver. Wish I'd been paying attention to what the lap times look like. Fawcett. Yeah. We can look that up. Yeah, 40 laps is probably about what we need in the car. Although, I think that's only going to explicitly apply. Yeah. Let's do the reduced fueling at the beginning, or for the first stop. All right, let's feckin' go. Okay. We get both engines to 90%. Can also auto the batteries. Although I think I want them to just about get them up to 100 first, and then we'll automate. Good start so far from Enrica. We are depending on things other than pure engine power for this race, which I think will end up being good. I think we'll automate everything at about 90%. Pino is the monopeller the car I really want to beat. We'll see how much of a factor tire wear does end up being. We do have a pretty good tire wear edge. Looking like there isn't really a magic bullet for this race. I'm losing about one stamina per minute. Which means extended runs aren't really going to be possible. Car is suddenly performing a lot stronger. At least for the moment. We just have to think about what we want out of our... Having at least 4-star marketability isn't the end-all be-all, but it would help our cause a lot. Now we're just kind of chucking ourselves by Series B. Uh-oh, the monopeller has fallen right off. That is a sight we actually do quite like seeing. Because this tire gap is only going to widen. I do like this because it does show that tire wear does matter to a degree. Man, we're losing heat on these a little bit quicker. Yeah, replacing Enrico actually would be the most immediate boost to our income, like sponsorship wise. But on the other side of it, it also requires us to lose potentially one of our best drivers. Monte Pella really is struggling. It's going to be one of these overtake or be overtaken situations. Crank that up. Now we have to see if we can even keep Pino behind us. I suspect the answer is yes. Got good things working in our favor for that. The tire wear gap here is the most. The most ever-present thing I can see at the moment. Just absolutely selling out to his tire wear now. I guess we'll see what happens. We've got good tire wear. Getting a real strong performance at the moment. I Well, Navarro gets a penalty. These Shinzu booms are very strong over a very long period of time. But yeah, that's what I'm primarily interested in at the moment. Just see what our long-term prospects are for retaining this position. It might fall to 6, but that still comfortably puts us ahead of Bexbach. For once. Puts us in a racing situation where we're ahead of Bexbach. Schober does not get a penalty. I do see Kanderstag fighting a lot. How are we looking? We lose the spot to Shinzu, which I think was eventually going to happen. I'm just kind of big picturing this race at the moment. We're not really racing Shinzu, and we're not really even racing Pamplona. We're racing Montepeller and Bexbach. Those are the cars that I want to crush. That's how I want us to be better than at the end of the day. Aliso Pitts. I'm just trying to decide who gets priority on pit. Looks like we're only going to end up needing like 38 laps. Holy. Front car gets priority. I think that's the safest way. The way that we're tending to do it. I think super softs do get all the way down to 10% before they cliff at the endurance level. Good go to Houghton, new set of tires, and 38 laps of fuel, I think, is about right. Boy, Sue, 38. Yeah, we have a balance stop for some reason, but I usually pick safe. Just had it done for Laura. We end up just behind the Monty Pillar. With quite a tire advantage, actually. Maybe we do equip 39 laps of fuel onto the car. That may be a thing to think about. And I'm not planning to run this way for very long. Mostly because Houghton's hot period doesn't last that long. Let's see if we can eat into this 20 second lead that this Lancaster has on us. It'll be interesting to see. Yeah, we are faster. At some point, we probably should show some signs of life on the tire usage. Just show that we're, like, still, you know, alive. You know the guy that started the race? Weird, they did not change drivers, but they did change tires. That's interesting. Certainly very, very interesting. The Shinzu boom is going to be a problem. Kojovic apparently is too. Jovic. Even though our wear is like two stages higher, we're still slower than him. Let's see. I think he might just be the strongest driver on that car. Boise is really nowhere in this race. Russian oil gives us a good crash. We just need to be careful because these tires are not meant to last forever, like especially the super softs. Alright, let's turn up the engine on the second car. Running hybrid mode, that's very weird. Strange to watch a guy run two stints, like you might as well switch drivers when you pit in. Don't let it max out. I guess we're actually racing Walker. Kind of. Where'd he get that burst of speed from? We have more than enough tire to hold that, but. And Kojovic has to pit in. Don't know for how long. Balak comes out. Oh, he came out ahead of Balak. Cool. Our second car did, anyway. Yeah, we're just kind of beached in here now. Kind of my most nervous little period with the car now. Just seeing what will happen. Just need to make these tires kind of last. Trying to get by. If this car has anything, it's going to show it under Vanderstead. It's kind of where my mind's at now. Thing we need right now is to be getting stuck behind these B cars. Turn it up a little bit on both of these cars. Pamplona is on a different level to us, so. We should be behind, like, basically all of them by the time all is said and done. And Kojovic has burned most of his race time, so we won't be seeing that in the Lancaster anytime soon. Tristan. The tire wear will be pretty close, but I think we'll be okay. We're in between a rock and a hard place with Boisu, since his stamina's running out. Isn't a real good solution for him. I understood. We'll go ahead and take like 40 laps. And I might stack Hewton right behind it. It just depends on whether they're far enough apart. The answer to that is probably no. Yeah, not a chance. The 39. Be a little bit better off on tire wear. With Jan's daughter. Once we're in the full hour. Let's see how this turns out. We're gonna end up behind a couple of the Vexbox and a lap down on one of the Shinzus. Balak's even going to get track position. That's a lot of lost time, actually. That difference in tire wear is not Not a particularly great sign for Balak. See how the cooling works. Still 59 degrees basically everywhere. It cannot affect an overtake on the outside. So you go from Jan's daughter to Laura. Got money color. That's an easy overtake. I just need to like make wild improvements to both cars. Vanderstad is hot. Let's use that. Ending up behind the Shinzu as well. Which is proving to be somewhat problematic. Trying to get myself off of being overtaken at the moment. But we're losing our left. Udris is actually kind of a attacking us, I guess. We did kind of need that. Wow. Oh, jeez. Yon's daughter is not running very strong. Which is kind of annoying because she's potentially, like, the strongest driver we have. In terms of, like, sheer drivability. Now we're behind Bexbach now, which is not... not great. Looking like it's going to be a bit of a fight, too. Nice little surge by. I'm hoping for Jan's daughter to wake up here at least a little bit. Get them eyes wide open and into the race. We're wearing a little worse than the Bexbach. Yeah, 6%. Probably aren't realistically getting third, but I'm just trying to be as competitive as possible. Seven seconds adrift. Alright, young daughter is hot. Let's get some zone in. Gap's up to 7% in tire wear now. Just try to get by on using like the go fast button. Kind of losing the plot here. Why would you stop burning battery on the straightaway? It just don't really make any sense. Give her the burn. Back to faucet. Not all that excitedly, but we are. Yeah, there's not really a whole lot to see here. I guess we're not really worried about component usage at this point. Nine's probably about right. Can probably double stack. Let's see. convinced about giving up the ghost here. We'll be fine. This is going to be the real tester, because we're basically not, like, ever turning the engine down here. Halfway. Lose 8th. Right, the real fight begins. Not doing a good job of getting by these B series cars in general. This is where the real tale is going to get told. Basically on how we handle this. Turn up the dials. Very, very strong drive from Udris. I'd be colored a little bit worried. We're kind of flipping positions with Gasper here. Let the tires get too hot again. At least it tells us. Udris is in the pits. And Mahler comes out. Very, very interesting. We've got a split on not Monopeller, but on Vexbach at the moment. Now it's going to be tire wear. Tire wear is going to tell the tale. As I feared, our engine declined a little bit. That still should be fine, though. Should. Key operative word in that sentence. Yeah, Gasper is just... I'm losing touch with those tires now. We have gone up a little bit in temp, but then we come back down. I might end up replacing both Etta and Vandersted. Boise's kind of on the edge too. Mahler. Yeah, we're actually gonna have better tires before too long. It's going to be interesting. Yeah, Halgerson comes up well behind. Just kind of curious when we lost our grip on this race with the Vexbach. Oh wow, Talisa's only 20 seconds behind. Our tire wear is a little bit better, but not a place that I would comfortably feel. Thank you. That is an advantage I want to clamp down on in future seasons. We do have a tire wear advantage. Just a matter of utilizing it. Don't overbake my tires, Fawcett. Push a little bit towards the end of their stints. So I just need to remember that the next qualifying lineup will be like Laura Hewton. Unless being left out of qualifying isn't a negative for a particular driver, then we just, I guess, always leave them out. I don't know. Taliso is fired up. How we doing? 46-46. Yeah. Brakes over here are a little bit alarming, but other than that, cars look good. Yeah, Fawcett is going to be like 2 or 3 years, and then it's going to be like, wow, she's a great driver. Laura is probably like a year or two away. Yeah, when Laura develops racecraft, like, she's going to become very dangerous. The racecraft is, like, the last thing that kind of comes in for her. She starts, like, generally very, like, smooth and overtake focused. Okay. Coming to the 2 hour mark. He Hewton's like the opposite. She's got the race craft, and the other tools are like lagging behind, like the fitness. Second car is starting to struggle a bit. Alright. Haras out, Laura. Yeah, no. Overly concerned with what we're seeing. The real fight here, I think, is going to begin fairly soon. We'll go through that straight away. Go to Hewton. So far, we're looking real good. Nothing to really worry about yet. Her run will be a little bit shorter, and Etta's will be a little bit longer. Fight's gonna be. Unless they just straight up like take a different tire, which they might. But if it's super soft versus super soft, it's gonna be interesting. Last hour is going to be Vanderstedt, which is our best driver. Maybe we put the hardest tire on her car. Giving it a little bit of a burst. -59 degrees. I don't really want the AI managing that. Udris did go for the soft. I think that's attackable, but not hugely. Padawan. Fight. That's a relatively easy overtake. Look at this mess. Let's get you sleeping. Yeah, the Bexbox strategy is looking kind of weird to me right now. I don't know. I guess we'll see how this pans out. Track temperature's too cool, so they're not... This ain't really gonna get them anywhere. Speed-wise, it's just devastating. The tires are gonna grain, and they're just not gonna perform. Their pace relative to Tolisso is what I'm really interested in. Boise's looking pretty decent. I'm feeling like we're standing still a little bit here. And it would be nice if you wake up. Wake up and win me some race. LBRB. And they've opted for Super Soft. Udris has started to push a little bit. Oh wow, look at how quick those tires are heating. Get her done. We need to leave some time for Etta to actually run proper. Doing it's weird in the moments they just try to preserve tires and all that. The boom, but we're not really fighting it for position. Basically, we're basically where we want to finish, hopefully. We actually do get them on the outside. Okay. We are quickly coming up towards endgame here. Getting this kind of a result over Montpellier will be huge. They do seem to have quite the tire wear advantage. At least at the moment. Give these cars a little bit more of a push. Like, this car basically started at the front of the grid. Very strange. Most we've done is like a 39 lap stint. Just peeking. Peeking and seeing. Oh wow, we're almost a lap ahead. That's just nuts. Like 14% down on tire wear. Yeah, probably gonna have to lean on to Vanderstedt on the harder tire. Probably just generally better for her. Probably about as far as we can go. Fuel me for 42 laps. And go. Where's our strategical strategery? Cannot decide. This is the end. I've got one of the Xbox behind us, way behind us, so it's fine. That's it. Pit strategy is complete. We'll be struggling for tire wear on either car. Jan's daughter, maybe slightly. Just slightly. Looks like Kanderstag's ahead in the race. And that's always when we get laps. When we're doing the lapping, we seem to lose a lot of time to relative to the rest of the field. I'm just trying to get some of that back. Get them to about the same place. Don't know how secure we are. Harlan Udris is in the pits. Yeah. That don't scare me too much. Noir staying out too long would be nice, but looks like that's also not going to happen. I think Dronia might be the threat. It's running at pace that's actually threatening to us. I'm just not entirely sure, like... melting through the tires. Flying, but they're also using the tires in a way that are not going to last very long. B series crest. Oh, that's an equip. That's potentially devastating to their championship hopes. Potentially. John Zotter, she's getting worse, which is not ideal. That Monty Peller has been really fast here at the end. I've been taken a little bit aback by it, but I think... the tire wear is a little bit more in our favor now. But it's too close for comfort. Beck's tire choice was just bad. Considering how close they kind of got to the end. I think they should have been a little bit more aggressive on tire choice. Wow, it looks like he elbowed his way by. I'm trying to figure out how this Monty Peller is this fast. Fast out of necessity because they knew they were stopping again. Wait. They didn't even switch. What are they doing? That's not gonna work either. Lorenz is kind of an actual threat now. Oh, come on, get by these guys. Thank you. The teammate is an 11th, I think. That's being somewhat problematic. The Renz is a really solid driver, unfortunately. That is not good for us. And I kind of burned through my defense mechanism. And that was just the Russian oil. Having to keep an eye on my mirrors behind. Kind of starting to run out of defensive power. Trying to pull away. The ability to do that is somewhat limited. What I'm trying to do is reduce the impact of her battery when she finally does burn it. Turn on overtake. Fine. I'm just out here fighting for my life. Just destroy and completely sell out this engine. Got enough excess fuel at the end, so. Let's turn those dials. We're about where we're gonna get there. The engine burn is going to make the difference here. Lorenz is kind of running into some difficulty with lap traffic. think we have to do the extra lap, but their competition is the finish on the trailing lap. So we can just kind of coast it. Yeah, that's fine. Then it burst, and then we kind of burst it, and they weren't able to, unable to keep up, which was good. Relatively good. Not bad. I think that's the last engine required race, so yeah, we just need to make more of an effort with the engine. Gal's daughter's gonna gain a cornering point. Well, not yet, but soon. Alright, nothing for anybody yet. We lose 220,000. I will probably end up needing to do something about the sponsorship. It's unfortunate, but it's a thing that needed to be done. 16 and 13. Couple of 15s. That one does a fresh start. Okay. No. Okay, there is a sponsorship slot that we need to work on. What do we got? Rear wing and suspension. Stick those in. What else? Top speed, useful. Alright. Let's work on that. We want to go to a standard merit pay. What's our current? We're currently at high merit. I want to oppose that. We just take upfront money. Bam. Two against. Go three against. I think that should be enough to ensure it fails. It would have failed anyway. Alright. Oh, third best again. Fifth best car. Go figure. That rear wing in there. All right, how are we It's weird to be considered fifth best, but I guess the wing is literally that bad. Fix it. That's annoying, however. But it is fine because we can. Because we can deal. Improve parts. Will we go like 2 days? Let me kind of work on both. What are we at? We have leapfrogged to second or third, fourth best. Just a matter of what we have time to do from here. I can't decide how good our car is. Behind, ahead, ahead, and way ahead. Okay. Engine is useful. So we're going to go ahead and end this here now, guys. I thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed. If you haven't already done so, feel free to follow up one time. Sound like sharing the YouTube end, and we will see you again next time. Till then, take care. Have a great one. And later on.